When would I squat with bands helping me do the lift? What is the difference between a band resisting my movement and a band helping my movement? So in this picture, we're in a, I'm holding a barbell. Sorry, I don't have a barbell with me. We're holding a barbell on our back with weight on it. And there are bands tied to that barbell and then fixed on the ceiling above me or fixed on the rack that I'm squatting in. And what they do is they stretch as we come down. Their tension ramps up, the resistance that they provide ramps up. And then it pushes me up where I'm almost totally unloaded at the top and I'm just relying upon the weight that's on the bar. So in this example, right, I'm able to load more plates on the bar because the bands are helping me go up. The resistance is real, or the assistance, let's say, the bands are not pulling me down, the bands are pulling me up. So the bands are assisting me, they are assisting me. So they are assisting me a lot when I'm at the bottom because they're most stretched. And then they are assisting me the least amount when I'm at the top. So what is the difference between a band resisting me and a band assisting me? Well, if you look at the curve of a band, right? So as a band stretches, it provides more resistance. We've talked about chain weight and adding chain weight, but chain weight is linear, right? Band weight is exponential, or band resistance is exponential. So if I'm resisting, or the band is resisting into me as I come up into the squat, it's pushing me down the most at the top. Now, if it's assisting me, the biggest change is not at the top. The top feels mostly like normal weight. It's at the bottom. And so what I can do with that is if I have some lifter who wants to train some more of their speed, generally tends to do really well with more speed movements, they can use this band to help them tap into their speed, to help them tap into extra force production and extra power production. Someone like me, I lift pretty slowly, so I get a little bit more out of a band resisting me because it gives me this extra tension, this extra force to push into. It helps me unlock that, right? That was my fake 1RM there. If I have somebody who's traditionally like a basketball player or a really fast power athlete, team sport athlete, they get away really well with training at higher velocities, at higher speeds. And research in velocity-based training that some of my good friends, Ty Terrell and Tony Giuliano, have done, is it's telling us if you are good at being fast, you probably don't need to be faster. You need to be able to resist forces and produce force better. And so the way that I can get them from, if somebody's really fast, right, they're good at a vertical jump. They're not so good at a 1RM, my fake deadlift or my fake squat, right? They're not really good at grinding at slow velocities. So what I can do is I can mix for them. I can give them maybe a little band resistance so they can still move a little faster, but not have to grind through really heavy, slow movements like a just straight weight, one rep maximum lift. Okay, so use band assistance with your faster people who like to, or who need to develop more force, develop more power.